Starcare Medical Laboratory.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته نرحب بكل المتابعين على صفحة مختبر ستاركير وعلى الفيسبوك والصفحات الأخرى وسعيد جدا أنه نواصل في سلسلة المحاضرات عن السيتولوجي مع الأستاذ الجامعي واختصاص المختبرات الطبية العلامة الأستاذ محمد الحويرس والأستاذ محمد هو واحد من أعلام السيتولوجي وعنوان المحاضرة اليوم هيكون عن الكواليتي مانجمنت من سايتوباثولوجي عن لابراتوري الأستاذ محمد حاصل على بكالوريوس علوم المختبرات الطبية من جامعة عبد الرحمن الأهلية إن هيستوباثولوجي عن سايتولوجي وكذلك حاصل على ماجستير هيستوباثولوجي عن سايتولوجي من يونيفرسيتي أوف ساينس أند تكنولوجي وسيرتيفايد بCytotechnologist from International Academy of Cytology and certified as International Technologist in Cytology from the American Society of for Clinical Pathology والأستاذ أيضا نشر عدد من البحوث في عدد من المجلات العلمية وقدم العديد من المحاضرات في المؤتمرات المحلية والعالمية ولديه خبرات عملية عمل محاضر بعدد من الجامعات السودانية ولديه خبرة واسعة في مجال الأكريديتيشن في الكاب والجي سي آي والآيسو 1589 وهو سينيور سايتولوجي سكرينر عن سايتوباثولوجي لكشر حاليا يعمل بدبي هيلث كير سيتي بالإمارات العربية المتحدة أنا سعيد جدا أستاذ الحويرس أنك تكون مواصل معنا للمرة الثانية وإن شاء الله نتمنى أن تقدم الكثير للناس في مجال السايتولوجي والآن ممكن تبتدي المحاضرة.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. شكرا كثير دكتور الفاتح الفرصة تحت الفرصة المرة الثانية ومن خلال المختبر ستاركير. والمرة دي حنتكلم في طبق مختلف طبق جديد في السيتولوجي اللي هو عن الكواليتي كنترول والكواليتي مانجمنت ان سايتوباثولوجي از جنرال اتمنى ان الصوت يكون واضح عشان نبدا
الصوت واضح جدا
طيب نبدا بالبرزنتيشن اباوت اللي هو كواليتي مانجمنت ان سايتوباثولوجي البرزنتيشن الاول كان تكلمنا بصوره جنرال عن السيتولوجي اللاين أو المجال بتاع السيتولوجي تكلمنا general points about the certification about the field of cytology itself والfuture role of cytologist in the laboratory and in diagnostic pathology اليوم هنتكلم عن ال quality management وطبعا the topic is very important the topic also includes many points outlines of the presentation بس بنحاول نسبة لأنه عندنا زمن محدد أنه ندي general idea about the quality in cytopathology طبعا في حاجات common في كل disciplines وفي كل specialties in medical laboratory في some points بتكون related of course to the cytology practice نسبة للخصوصية بتاعت المجال بتاع cytology or cytopathology بالنسبة للlecture, outlines of the lecture, we will speak about definition and terms, because as you know, it's very important to know general terms that we use in the quality in cytology or in medical laboratory in general. About the accreditation itself, اللي هو العملية بتاعت الاعتماد في cytology laboratory, طبعا الاعتماد بيكون for all the lab, all disciplines. For each department, we have certain requirement and checklist. according to the accreditation body. Also, we'll talk about the procedures. It's very important. The procedures is like the practical aspects, SOPs, the standard operational procedures in the cytology. We'll talk about the QC, quality control, and the quality assurance. We'll show the difference between atom. Cytology staff, of course, also is very important because in the criteria for the cytology staff, we have different categories, different role, and different job description for each cytology staff. And also we'll talk generally about safety in cytology also, which is very important because we have a different type of specimens that we receive in the lab. Some specimen with hazardous material, like the fresh samples sometimes. Also, we have to talk about also the safety. In general, the achieving and maintaining and improving accuracy, timeline, aligns and reliability are major challenges for health laboratories. For this standard, first we have to achieve, and the other thing we have to maintain also this quality. And with the monitoring every time, also we will improve the cytology service. Now, we are also monitoring every time for the procedures or the quality measures in the lab in different aspects, how to improve either CAMPA deficiency or any issue in any step of the cytology laboratory. And also as a definition, as you know, the quality control defined as a system for verifying and maintaining a desired level of quality in an individual test or process. So a quality control, it's the system, all steps that are done inside the lab to maintain a desired level of quality, the practical aspect. And this quality control activities span the testing process from the moment of a specimen collection until the time of the physician receives the report. برضو زي ما عارفين انه there's multi steps in the cytology lab. From the receiving of the specimen, we have to identify the specimen. Is it acceptable? Is it fulfill all the criteria of satisfactory specimen? The accessioning, checking the specimen and the fixative, the request form and the information of the patient, the clinical history of the patient. Kula is very important from the receiving. And as general, as you know, in the control, we have three steps. In cytology, we have the pre-analytical, analytical, and the post-analytical steps in cytology. Tistamir ma'ana quality control activities is still the moment that the physician receive the report, and we'll see the different steps. Regarding the quality assurance itself, is a planned and systematic set of quality activities. They are here a checklist or a guidelines which we have and focus on providing confidence that the quality requirement will be fulfilled. And quality assurance should include both internal quality control, as you know, and external quality assurance. And internal quality control here, all the steps that we are doing inside the lab, within the lab. For example, checking the specimen acceptability, checking the fixative, step data staining also. Cool step of the quality control, control slides to check the instruments and the staining and dyes, everything there here, quality control. And the external quality control or external quality assurance, it's like in cytology, it's different than in other discipline or other fields. Here we've got exchange of slides or slide that received from accredited bodies to evaluate the competency of the cytology staff, including a local cyto screener or a cytology biomedical scientist or a cytopathologist. Okay, in cytology laboratory quality can be maintained by continuous monitoring. طبعا قلنا المونيتورنج او المراقبه بتاعت التست is very important. ودائما في كل اللابراتوري اللي هي بتكون accredited lab بيكون في staff اللي هي quality officer. طبعا بيكون في quality manager also. And as you know, we have for each department there is a supervisor. اللي هو المشرف على department, a supervisor. Who could responsible to check and to monitor all the quality control aspects and measures inside the lab. بتأكد من كل خطوات بتاعت quality control from receiving of the specimen till reporting of cytology sample. The standards can be agreed at local, national, or international levels. طيب احنا عندنا set of standards for cytology. This set of standards in cytology is agreed by accredited body اللي هي الجهات بتعطي اللاب الاعتماد. For example, in USA we have the College of American Pathologists, the CAP accreditation. Well, CAP is more specialized because we have checklists in the CAP for different discipline. Yani for example, we have CAP cytopathology checklist. We have CAP anatomic pathology checklist, CAP hematology checklist. بعدين في حاجة بقولها common checklist. Common checklist لأنه في حاجات مشتركة inside the lab. يعني بتكون في كل different disciplines بيكون we have common checklist. فهي more detailed CAP وبعدين more specialized for each discipline. For microbiology, for molecular, for hematology. And for UK, we have CPA, اللي هو clinical pathology accreditation. It's body for accreditation of the clinical lab or for laboratories. And we have, of course, ISO 15189, which is mainly for a medical laboratory and is used generally in Europe and other countries. Of course, as a hospital, as you know, we have the accreditation, which is a GCI, Lower Joint Commission International, which is for all the hospitals. This includes all clinics and pharmacy, the surgery department, cooler department. And so it deal with general requirement like general procedure and general SOPs. So for the CAP and CPA, he are more specialized in clinical laboratory. طيب دائما نتكلم على quality. عندنا الصورة دي بتعبر على ال difference من quality. طبعا this is welcome to Germany. دي بداية الحدود أو borders between Germany and another country. وصراحة another country أنا ما عارفها عشان ما يقوم يزعل مننا، لكن دي borders أو الحدود بين ألمانيا ودولة تانية أوروبية. فبنلاحظ هنا الفريق هم بيهتموا بالdetails. شوفوا lines في الستريت والsign والsignals والخطوط الموجودة في الشارع والquality بتاع الشارع، واضح أنه فريق بيهتموا بالdetails. ف this will avoid طبعا many things، المشاكل ممكن تحصل في الطريق والاكسيدنت. تدينا example ليه انه how to deal with the details, how to maintain the quality and how to improve. الفرق واضح بين اللابراتوري اللي بيكون عنده quality control system, internal quality control system و external quality control system، بين ال other lab اللي بيكون هي is not accredited. طيب دائما برضه بنتكلم عن ناس السيتولوجي اللي هم بنهزر يعني في حته بتاع السيتولوجي، يقول هو دائما هم اللي بدوا المشاكل في الكلينيكال لابوراتوري اساسا، لانه طبعا السجوك هو ذكرناه المره اللي فاتت في المحاضره، انه الوول ستريت جورنال 1987 ببلش بيبر اباوت الباب تيست السنسيتيفيتي اوف ذا باب تيست. One of the PAP test misses much cervical cancer through labs error. At that time, طبعا screening program كان بدأ with the cervical cytology. كان في مشاكل في quality. Mainly مثلا في ال تكلمنا عن انه مشكلة كانت في workload. حتى في reports كتبوا انه sometimes the cyto screener or cytologist screen 300 slides per day. يعني 300 سلايد في اليوم. فأكيد حصلت a lot of mistakes. If you screen 300 slides per day, of course you will miss many abnormal and cases. فدي أدت لأنه السنسيتيفيتي أنه في question about the pap test أو pap smear. ف Department of Health and Human Services in the United States طوال قام بالكلاية اللي هي معروفة Clinical Laboratory Improvement Amendment اللي هي published in 1988 أنه for the cytology lab طبعا هو بعد ذلك كانت في كل اللابراتوري في كل الأقسام أنه we have to do action to improve the service in the clinical laboratory اللي هي بسموها Clinical Laboratory Improvement Amendment هي طلعت 1988 After that, Clinical Laboratory Improvement Act. وبقت معتمدة من الـ Department of Health زي وزارة الصحة في United States وشملت كل الديسيبلينز الموجودة في المختبرات. فهي كانت إحنا بنقول أنها هي بداية المشكلة كانت من سيتولوجي لكن جاءت بالنهاية بفائدة لكل الفيلد لأنه وضعوا standards و quality control measures to maintain the quality in the clinical laboratory as general. لأنه ما قالوا cytology, قالوا clinical laboratory improvement amendment. طيب, for this, الكلاية in 1988, طبعا في main points هم تكلم عنها ولازم يحصل فيها improvement. For example, workload limits for cytotechnologists. لازم يكون في workload limits. The screener should screen certain number of slides per day. يعني سكرين ما يكون عدد كبير عشان طبعا كل ما زاد العدد بعدين في مسائل بتاعت السيفتي وانه لازم يكون في بريكس هاو تو سكرين ذا سلايدز كل الكواليتي كنترول بروسيديرز بعد ذاك ستارتد فروم ذات تايم الري سكرينينج اوف ذا سلايد باي ذا سايتولوجي سوبرفايزر اور باي سايتوباثولوجيست ذا كورليشن بتوين سايتولوجي اند هيستوباثولوجي ريبورت طبعا زي ما قلنا بالنسبة لنا إحنا الـ histopathology is still the gold, the golden standard for cytology. So we have to control between or to compare between cyto and histopathology reports. الـ other important points اللي هي الـ PT أو الـ proficiency testing برضو دخلت لمجال الـ clinical laboratory from that time. As you know, PT في كل الـ department عم بتفرق لأنه عندنا cytology generally إحنا نتكلم عنه as a qualitative test. Not like other tests for hematology or for chemistry, for example. ففي PT في كل disciplines in clinical laboratory. هنتكلم عن PT في cytology هتكون كيف. About the accreditation, اللي هو الاعتماد in clinical laboratory. What is the accreditation? The health mechanism by which an agency or an organization evaluate and verify that an organization's service or a program of study meet specific predetermined standards. They put standards, يعني standards احنا عندنا مثلا في الكاب هي checklist. Checklist فيها standards. في البداية طبعا بدوك checklist بتاعه انه you have to follow this standards and you have to apply this standard in your lab. بعد ذلك بيكون في الخطوة الثانية انه to follow up step by step لانه to comply or to fulfill all the criteria of the standards. And after that, I will fill an inspection. And for example, as for CAP, an inspection become biannual, who are every 2 years. They inspect the lab and they check all the steps and that the lab meet the criteria for the accreditation. فلما تقول أنا عندك this lab is accredited by ISO or CAP or CPA, that means this lab meet the minimum standards and requirement by this agency or by this organization. And the accreditation, طبعا, كل ال steps at the accreditation مربوطة بالaccuracy, which is the level of agreement between the diagnosis offered by the laboratory and the gold standard. بالنسبة لحب السيتولوجي ذكرنا قبل كده أنه الجولد standard بالنسبة لنا is a history or a biopsy if possible. Or is that available? We have biopsy report. We correlate between the cytology and biopsy report. This is, and after that we have the measurement to evaluate the accuracy of the cytology report. For example, طبعاً بالنسبه للناس السيتولوجي they know اذا قلنا مثلا we report the case as low grade in the cytology if there is biopsy it should be also low grade or CIN 1 if the high reported as high grade it should be in the histopathology as CIN 3 or CIN 2 regarding the external quality control in cytology the core of external quality control is their participation in a slide exchange program among different laboratories and comparison of diagnosis as like in the PT يعني برسل slides from عندنا the slides are available حاليا مثلا from the CAP slide for gynecology slide for non gynecology also and at ASCP also they have PT program they send the slides and after that they evaluate the report and the result from that lab for the proficiency testing and they share this their evaluation with the lab with a minimum percentage of we have you to pass the PT or the proficiency testing اللي هي 90% like in the CAP we have to go to achieve 90% of the results and if there is any mistakes or miss of abnormal smear they should be what we call corrective action اللي هو كيف to make a discussion for this case and how to make more training like that so as a division gold standard اللي هو reference again is which activities or results are measured and as we mentioned in cytology our gold standard is still is the histopathology oral biopsy report and the guidelines it's a systematic recommendation designed to help the operators to choose the best procedure in expected situation and طبعا guidelines we have different guidelines from CAP from ISO and from CPA for example in UK and we have to follow this set of guidelines and standards طيب certification is very important and related to quality because it's we will make sure that a practitioner or a cytology staff is certified and they have a certain level of competency اللي هو الكفاءة المهنية والprofessional competency of the practitioner or the site screener or the cytologist at different levels احنا تكلمنا And we have first the graduation and should be from accredited or approved college. College after that, the training. Step تانية طبعا كلمنا عنها كان في إنه we have to do training in cytology and then after that the license or licensure from Minister of Health or the Department of Health and board certification. This is for both. طبعا احنا نتكلم for cyto screener or biomedical scientist and for pathologist. There is a requirement or standard for first of all the graduation, training and board certification. This also because يعني this is the core of the quality. يعني نتكلم عن الستاف. نتكلم عن الكواليتي. The staff they do the report and evaluation of the smears. فلازم يكون عندهم competency. Because cytology error is very serious. طبعا كل الايرورز في اللاب is very serious and the consequences اكيد. بالنسبة لنا في cytology for example احنا نضرب مثل in both sides هي مشكلة. يعني if you report false negative is a problem for the patient and also if you report false negative also is another problem for the patient. يعني for example إذا تكلمنا عن pap smear if you report high grade false positive high grade the patient will undergo colposcopy surgery and biopsy and this is additional cost for the health insurance for and for the patient itself yani بيكون في a lot of complication for false positive of course also false negative if we miss any abnormal pap smear also another problem because it will the patient will have lesion or any pathological condition and it's missed by the cytologist. فأساس الكواليتي عندنا في السيتولوجي اللي هو الكواليفيكيشن or competency of the cytology staff. the activities of the lab, when we set a quality management program, as general, we have to see the different activities we have in the lab. We have four stages, which is the specimen reception. At the specimen reception, we have control measures, and how to evaluate this specimen is accepted or satisfactory, or if there is any problem about the specimen. We have criteria for rejection of the specimen also. For example, if the specimen is unlabeled or we receive, for example, mismatch between the request form and the slide, or broken slide, or any criteria that this specimen is unacceptable to be processed. And after that, if the specimen is accepted, the second step or the second stage will be laboratory processing of the sample. This includes many steps. Here's a sample to produce a slide. To produce slide by processing, staining, and of course, we can do this manual by conventional slide. In the cytology lab, as you know, we have the machine to prepare the slide. We have liquid-based cytology and cytocentrifuge and cytospin. These all machines will prepare the slides. And after that, the next step will be the staining of the slide. The third stage is very important here, microscope analysis, a whole screening, which will be done usually by cyto screener or medical laboratory scientist or by consultant pathologist. احنا بنتكلم على step لأنه في كل step في quality control في standards we have to follow. The fourth stage or the final stage, as you know, is the reporting of the specimen. طيب لو جينا شفنا في بشكل عام عندنا after طبعا عندنا the screeners they do the primary screening for the slides and they report negative pap smear. وتكلمنا كان في presentation الفات عن screeners نفسهم we have different level of screeners في advanced practitioners they can report negative and positive pap smear. So the negative the pap smear should be reviewed by also senior cytotechnologist or senior cytologist or quality control check. And after that, if it's negative or inadequate, it can be reported. If it's the slide is abnormal, it should be also checked by the senior cytologist and then should be also reviewed by pathologist before the final reporting. The, for example, the system in United States or America. طبعا في ال advanced practitioner اللي حنتكلم عن experience in UK, advanced practitioner can report and sign both normal and abnormal pap smear. We have different quality measures in cytology, as you know. One of the most important is unsatisfactory for evaluation. Yani after processing and after staining and under the microscope, we evaluate the specimen. This specimen is inadequate. And there is criteria for this unsatisfactory for both conventional pap smear and liquid-based cytology, for example. And this is also important quality indicator. As a cytology lab, we have to count and to see the percentage of unsatisfactory smears every year. For example, if we have high percentage, high number of unsatisfactory smear, and now there is a problem, we have to address the problem. We have to check the kind of problem in the, for example, the kind of sampling collection, the kind of problem in the staining or any technical part. So we have a percentage, like for example, we have liquid-based cytology, should be less than 1%, an unsatisfactory rate, for example. And we also count the cell, the way of the count. For conventional, we have from 8,000 to 12,000 cells and a minimum of 5,000 cells in the liquid-based cytology. Few other factors that like the blood or inflammation and mucus, the air drying, and poor fixation, they are technical, preclude the interpretation of the pap smear, and also we consider it as unsatisfactory. two points important, which is L-smear, N-smear contain abnormal cells should never be categorized as inadequate. يعني إذا عندنا smear few هي abnormal cells, حتى لو few مثلا blood or air drying or inflammation, a few number of scanned cell or low cellularity, but contain abnormal cells should be reported as satisfactory. And the inadequate smear must be repeated also as in the recommendation, because you never know if the patient still has any abnormality in the cervix or in the pap smear, so it should be repeated. So we have the فكرة عامة عن the unsatisfactory as a quality measures in the different slides here, as you can see. One slide is unsatisfactory because mainly there is blood in the background and there is very few squamous epithelial cells. Another slide, also very few squamous epithelial cells and mucus. This slide mainly inflammatory cells like neutrophils. There is no epithelial cells, so also considered as unsatisfactory. And the last slide here, we have unsatisfactory due to insufficient squamous cells or epithelial cell component. So we have criteria to report smear as unsatisfactory, and the recommendation will be to repeat the smear or sampling for cervical cytology, it's also very important and mandatory in the request form. It should include certain clinical information and data about the patient, like an age, patient name, the ministerial status of the patient, like an LMP, if there is any history of abnormal pap smear, if there is any history, previous history of risk factor, like in cervical cancer, of course, a human papillomavirus considered as risk. Also, the source of a specimen is very important, because we have different source of specimen. It can be vaginal cytology, it can be cervix. If the patient is post total hysterectomy, there will be vaginal vault smear. So we expect a certain type of epithelial cells. And the clinical correlation is very important. يعني بنضرب مثلا for example, postpartum, يتوقع انه الاسمير حيكون atrophic smear if it's postpartum. So the correlation with the clinical is very important, and the history of the patient. If I'm screening a slide and I عارف انه this patient before has abnormal pap smear or high risk HPV, also is very important. So by the CLIA 88 also, it's it was mandatory to complete all important clinical data and history of the patient. بنتكلم طبعا جنرال احنا نجي معروفين في الحاجات المهمه في اللي هي سواء كانت تكنيكال او الايفالويشن اوف سلايدز. It's very important also we have the contamination control in the, this is طبعا technical في الستيننج. في فرق طبعا بين الستين, الناس بيستخدموا الستين اللي هي الستيننج مانيوال ستيننج and ستيننج باي اوتو ستينر او ستيننج ماشين. Still contamination can be, in both cases can be happening. We have to prevent the contamination. So we have criteria. This is also mentioned in the CAP checklist, in the CAP cytopathology checklist, and how to prevent the contamination. For example, the dyes that we use in the stain should be filtered daily by filter paper, using filter paper. And there is some reagents that we use in the cytology lab, it should be replaced daily. يعني كل يوم لازم نغير الزيلين والكحول. الستين should be filtered. It's highly recommended that gynae and non-gynae samples be stained separately. طبعا we should have the two sets of stains, one for gynae specimen and one for non-gynae, to prevent the cross-contamination between different samples. And the contamination control is essential step to avoid the carryover or malignant floaters, the contamination between different type of specimens, the malignant floaters, there can be contamination. حتى عندنا في اللاب sometimes there can be highly cellular specimen, malignant specimen, highly cellular, فيها cells كثيرة. We will change and replace all solutions or reagents. لأنه يكون في possibility أنه ممكن يحصل contamination from one sample to another sample. طيب المين source of error واللي كانت بداية بتاعت المشاكل في البابي سمير اللي هي الفالس نيجاتيف زي ما عارفين. حتتكلمنا عنه في الـ في الوول ستريت جورنال البيبر كانت about أنه بيحصل missing للأبنورمال أو للباثولوجيك كونديشن باي بابي سمير. And after that they started this improvement program in the clinical laboratory. So as you know, the source of this false negative, طبعا احنا اتكلمنا قلنا انه both false negative and false positive is a problem بالنسبه لللابراتوري, بالنسبه للpatient او للhealth care providers in general. But false negative, it could be mainly two result from two reasons. The first one is the sampling error. يعني في الحالة دي it's not from the error is not from the side of the lab. It's from the clinic. يعني احنا عارفين مثلا البابي سمير الجينيكولوجيست or a nurse of the gynecologist will collect the papi smear from the cervix. So the collection device does not sample abnormal cells or there is insufficient transfer of this lesional cell or abnormal cell from collection device اللي هي for example brush or spatula to the glass slide وحتى في الليكويد بيساتوري. فدي sampling error. From the lab side also there is laboratory error. This is mainly on an interpretation or screening under the microscope as you know. يعني في abnormal cells في slide but either screening اللي هي abnormal cells are missed. فهنا تجي the importance of ال 10% rescreening اللي اتكلمنا عنه وال rescreening by senior cytologist because to avoid missing any abnormal cells. Or interpretation error like the abnormal cells are misinterpreted as benign. يعني slide فيها abnormal cells like in a screener or pathologist or cytologist call it as benign or reactive change or atrophy or whatever, but it's abnormal cells. So mainly it can be sampling or laboratory error. And from our side in the laboratory, we can prevent this screening errors or laboratory errors by the rescreening and the slide by a senior cytologist. طيب regarding the staff in cytology, we have different categories for the staff. And there is a criteria, this is also mentioned in the CAP cytopathology checklist, that there is a requirement, prerequisites, and there is criteria for each staff. This criteria is the graduation from the college and cytopathologist from the Faculty of Medicine at MBBS, cytology biomedical scientist or medical laboratory scientist. After that, they should get a suitable training in cytology. And after that should be board certified. اللي هي كل مرة بنقولها ثلاث خطوات. Graduation, training, and board certification. This is mandatory requirement to practice. And this requirement is important because it will make sure that we have competent staff. That staff went through faculty and proper well training in the hospital, based training, laboratory based training, and also is certified by a board. Like, for example, in the for pathologists, طبعا عندهم ال Royal College of Pathologists in UK, في الكاب والMD في US عندهم different system. For medical laboratory scientists, cytology, maybe we have two main certification, اللي هم ال ASCPi and the American Society for Clinical Pathology and IAC, which is International Academy of Cytology. A technical staff, this staff is doing only lihal processing and preparation of samples. في مرات بيقول عالم تكنولوجيست ممكن يكون جنرال لابراتوري تكنولوجيست او سايت تكنيشن. Their role is not in screening or interpretation. mainly the role is preparation and processing of samples. We have a clerical staff or administrative personnel, which is very important because a lot of work in the cytology. Most of the lab, they use the LIS system, laboratory information system. So this LIS, all this like uploading of the results, checking of the bills, accessioning, uploading of reports, كل في السيستم دي بيتم by personnel اللي هم administration or بسموهم also medical transcriptionist or clerk staff also in the lab. Of course in the lab we should have also, this is also required by CAP or by all the accreditation bodies, اللي هي job description for each staff in the lab. So the job description will contain all the qualification required, the activities should be covered or performed in the lab. So quality is everyone's responsibility because as we mentioned, this all staff is participating in this quality measures. It's not a responsibility, time a rough misunderstanding and the quality is responsibility of quality officer or a quality manager, for example. No, the technology, they have their own, for example, the technology that are doing the processing while staining. They have to check ML daily control slide. They have to check quality of the stain, machine, مثلاً, daily maintenance of the machine, and كل preventive measures in the bench work. So this is all steps of the quality. A quality officer or quality manager, for example, they should check every time all documentations or SOPs. Inspection every time also to check and كل quality measure is performed in the lab. So for cytology lab, نتكلم طبعا عن ergonomics اللي هي بيئة العمل يعني باللغة العربية طبعا بيئة العمل في السيتولوجي because usually السيتولوجي screeners by اللي هي الكلاينت they should screen maximum 8 hours per day يعني مفترض ما يعمل screening more than 8 hours per day 8 ساعات في اليوم دي طبعا من ناحية بتاعت اللي هو occupation safety بالنسبة للابراتوري staff يعني you can't sit for the with the in the microscope for long hours. فمن ناحية بتاعت ergonomics هم حطوا criteria also انه how to screen the slide انه you should have اللي هو بسموها breaks البريك اللي هي كل فترة يعني بتاخد بريك من السكريننج we will be involved in other administration or bench work or whatever and the microscope also how to set the microscope how to check فدي كلها كريتيريا في اللاب عندنا بعدك نتكلم عن السيفتي also الأهمية بتاعت الهازرد هو السيستم والأشياء دي طيب تكلمنا على الإرجونومكس قبل شوية اللي هي بيئة العمل for the cytology as you can see this cytologist sitting in the microscope As ergonomics, في وضع معين في اللي هو position in the chair لأنه they screen for long hours per day. إحنا قلنا زي ما قلنا الناس عادة screen بيكون from 5 maximum 8 hours أقل شيء 5 hours هم بيقولوا كده الستاندرد بتاعتهم من 5 ساعات ل 8 ساعات. فـ this 5 to 8 hours اللي هي من ناحية بتاعت ergonomics لازم يكون في position معين في الميكروسكوب and we have الستاندر برضو مثلا في اللي هو يكون موجود الكمبيوتر for the LIS for the reporting and see مثلا spaces هي الموجودة في اللاب شفنا ال other picture here also we have in the lab طبعا احنا في السيتولوجي بطريقة سيمبل اللي هو البروسيسنج عندك this for example this machine this is small machine this is thin prep to prepare a liquid based cytology temp prep and there is another machine for staining. اللي هي الخطوة بتاعتنا اللي هي preparation of the slide and then staining of the slide. الخطوة الثالثة زي ما شايفينها في السلايد اللي هي microscopic evaluation. فالمسألة بتاعت في ستاندرد توضعت للإيرجونومكس اللي هي البيئة العمل اللي هو to avoid مثلا يحصل wrist pain or في الهاند أو في الريست أو الباك pain because of the long hours sitting in the microscope. Procedures في cytology of course it's also generally like the SOPs اللي هي for each step. For example, if we are processing with the liquid-based cytology or conventional slide, we have SOPs, standard operating procedure. We have to follow these SOPs. حتى ما نحصل مثلا inspection, ما نحصل تفتيش من الكاب or whatever, they will check, بسألوك أول حاجة بقول لك where is your SOPs, and they will check if you are following this procedure and policy of the lab. And this protocols and procedure should be followed by all staff. All staff should be informed. Other measures like we have to check all the labels, مثلا في reagents, the expired date. طبعا we shouldn't never use expired reagent after control. Filtration of the stains. عندنا طبعا a daily control slide اللي هو before we start the batch, we have to do control slide. This control slide, we will check the quality of the reagents, the quality of the nuclear stain, and the quality of the counter stains. And we have, you run one or two slides as control, then it will be checked by the cytology supervisor or senior cytologist. If the staining, for كل الحاجات في السلايد اللي هي nuclear staining, cytoplasmic stain, and مثلا unmounting, حتى cover slipping, everything is okay, then you will run your batch after that. بالنسبة للإكويبمنت, instruments اللي هي طبعا maintenance. Maintenance في part من maintenance بيكون responsibility of the laboratory staff or technologist. There is another part of this maintenance is responsibility of الكمباني أو البروفايدر أوف ذيس ماشين اللي هو بيعملوا ال بريفنتيف مينتنس حاليا نشوف هسه نتكلم. طيب the machines that we use in cytology lab we have mainly of course as you know we have microscope طبعا this كل ال cytology depend on microscope evaluation اللي هو assessment under the microscope centrifuge and cytospin. Cover slipper or cover slipping. Processing for a slide like liquid-based cytology, cytospin and stainer. The question is how to maintain. This is our responsibility. We have to do daily QC and there is logbook and to check these machines. There is a weekly and monthly maintenance of these machines and preventive maintenance. Now we will speak about how to screen a slide. تقريبا this is the core of the cytology practice. أنه حتى بالنسبة لي أنه how to screen the slide, they put recommendation and standards how to screen the slide. Like how to place the slide, how to use which objective in the screening, lower times 10 objective. We have to cover all the slide to avoid missing any abnormal cells. We ensure that you overlap and scanned area, طبعا overlapping here under the field under the microscope is a circle, and you have to overlap from one circle to another circle to make sure that you cover all the smear. But that is if any suspicious cells or abnormal cells should be examined or evaluated by high magnification, like times 40. A slide here, abnormal or questionable cell must be marked in the slide اللي هو بنعمل على الدوت بالبن. Now this is a slide ده اللي بقول عليه طبعا virtual slide. This is the تقريبا حيكون الفيوتشر اوف screening and training in cytology. What is a virtual slide? Virtual slide هو slide. The whole slide is in the computer, in the computer في screen, في computer or laptop or whatever. You have the options for magnification, different magnification, as you can see here. طبعا هنا this is the magnifications. You can use 4, 10, 20, 40, 100, يعني different magnification. في الطرف بتاع الصورة هنا شايفين السيركل دي كل السلايد. وطبعا دي liquid based cytology غالبا دي thin prep. This is the whole slide. And after that, in the center of the screen, you'll see the cells at, for example, times 10. So, طبعا الابنورمال cells هي marked by pen, اللي هو الجرين هنا pen. This is for final evaluation by the senior cytologist or by a pathologist. So, this is طبعا ده كلام عن digital pathology. It's a different topic, it's a very complicated topic. والسكرينينج ممكن يكون virtual في الميكروسكوب أو في ال sorry في اللابتوب أو في الكمبيوتر. You can use different magnifications and you can mark the abnormal cells اللي هنعمل على dots like this. And after that will be final evaluation by senior cytologist or consultant cytopathologist. And I think this is low grade or something at that mark or finally. يعني أسير الحين الصورة شايفينها this not under the microscope. They are virtual. Slide. okay, as we mentioned before about the improvement act or improvement amended by clinical laboratory improvement act or amendment, LICLIA 1988, they focus in main things that to improve the quality of the cytology بشكل عام أو screening in cytology. The first point اللي هي screening work limit. لازم يكون عندنا work limits اللي هي how many slides you screen per day. في الـ US, United States, تقريبا بيقولوا أنه 100, maximum 100 slides every 24 hours. طبعا نظام by 24 hours. إذا كان نظام shift مثلا in the UK, maximum 50 slides, maximum 50 slides. Rescreening of 10% of the negative, Pap-smear. As you know, this is we select 10% of the negative Pap-smear and we rescreen to make sure by senior cytologist to avoid any missing of abnormal cells. if we have currently a malignant case or cancer, we should review all negative previous pap smear. دي طبعا as internal quality control is very important. يعني إذا جاك أي slide, for example, حاليا هو high grade or cancer, you should تراجع كل slide اللي قبلها في فترة بتاعت 5 years, اللي هي بسموها 5 years look back. 5 years look back اللي هي تراجع slide قبل 5 سنوات كانت negative. ليه كانت negative؟ إذا كان عندك high grade now, كيف انه قبل سنه او سنتين او لحد 5 سنوات تكون نيجاتيف. فبيحصل كثير في اللاب وناس بتلقى انه لما نعمل ريفيو للبريفيوس نيجاتيف بيلقوا انه they miss sometimes abnormal cells. But this is good for internal quality control. Also, we mentioned that histopathology is our gold standard. So the review discrepancies اللي هو disparities or discrepancies between a pap and biopsy result. Correlation. بالنسبة لل discrepancy in cytology classified as minor discrepancy and major discrepancy. كيف minor and major؟ طبعا minor مثلا إذا في cytology قلت أنا low grade وبعد ذاك أخذوا biopsy والبيوبسي كانت high grade or thin 3 for example. هنا في discrepancy لكن minor discrepancy. يعني أنا في النهاية في cytology قلت abnormal. الميجر ديسكريبنسي إذا كان في السيتولوجي for example I call it negative and في البيوبسي كانت high grade. طبعا دي ديسكريبنسي كبير جدا ميجر ديسكريبنسي. So it's also for quality control good. يعني نحن نشوف ان اللاب minor discrepancies or major discrepancies. الاسكس طبعا هو category questionable in cytology. ناس cytology عارفين انه نقول atypical squamous cells اللي هي بتعتبر يعني في changes not a definite abnormal cells. There is a question, and this cell is reactive, or this cell is low grade or abnormal cells, but we call it as atypical squamous cell. So this atypical cell should be correlated with the HPV result. لأن عارفين طبعا إحنا في السير بيجي هنتكلمنا عن الجاني سايتولوجي. Cervical cancers mainly is caused by high risk human papilloma virus. So evaluation of the high risk HPV with the ASCPi is very important. وزي ما ملاحظين ما ذكروا إنه to evaluate the HPV with the low grade or high grade. لأنه already this is a very clear definite abnormal pap smear. لكن الباب سمير بيكون فيها question اللي هي equivocal بيسموها pap smear. Should be correlated with the human papillomavirus, if available. طبعا. And if in some labs, unfortunately, we don't have human papillomavirus or a facility for molecular testing. So in this case, we have to use a different method. بالنسبة للscreening workload records is very important. We have to maintain 100 slides per 24 hours. The US system. In UK, here maximum 50 في الدوام الواحد أو في اللي هو الدوام تاعهم ممكن يكون 8 to 9 hours, maximum 50 slides. And this amount of time spent during this time should be maximum 8 hours. الأوشن نفسهم اللي هو safety incubation, safety اللي هو الاثوريتي they said 5 hours في الكاب بيتكلم عن 8 hours يعني minimum 5 hours per day to 8 hours per day for screening because as we mentioned as a safety for the cytologist you should not sit for the microscope for long hours. Also, the Clinical Laboratory Improvement Act recommend 10% rescreening of the negative cases. So we should screen 10% of the negative cases by cytology screening as internal quality control. This quality measure also very important, retrospective rescreen, 5 years look back. If we have a current high grade or cancer case, we should rescreen retrospectively all negative pap smear within 5 hours, 5 years back to check if there is any a negative pap smear misinterpreted as negative and is false negative pap smear. Also, the gold standard اللي هي البيوبسي and all the quality measures اللي هنتكلم عنها عندنا طبعا false negative and false positive واللي true negative or true positive بنطلع منها quality measures بتاعتنا اللي هي specificity, sensitivity, negative predictive value and positive predictive value. So with this is with correlation with the biopsy هنتكلم عنها هو طبعا الجولد ستاندرد mainly how to measure. This is very important. Okay, as we mentioned also, an atypical smear, atypical squamous cells of undetermined significance should be correlated with the test of the human papillomavirus, a little high risk HPV if it's available. وبعدين عملوا مثال, for example, if the lab عندنا 20% of the ASCPi is actually positive for high risk HPV. That means this lab is overcalled the ASCPi cases. كيف يعني إذا كان عندي 20% من the ASCPi cases هي بس فقط 20% هي positive للhuman papillomavirus. That means we overcall. إحنا بنكتب كثير ASCPi هي في الحقيقة ما أكتب لأن 20% بس من cases هي positive للhuman papillomavirus. إذا كان برضو lab 80% of the ASCPi cases هي positive for high risk HPV. In the other side, here برضو أنا we undercall يعني بنذكر عدد بسيط من الأسكس فهي لازم تكون in between. لأنه في النهاية طبعا الـ atypical squamous cells هي depend on يعني is not a different from one cytologist to another cytologist, there is different reports and it's like equivocal is mean, so we have to correlate with the high risk HPV. The annual statistics also is very important اللي هي ال statistics والإحصائيات السنوية في اللاب بتدينا indication ل الكواليتي بتاعنا مثلا a number of cytology cases total number and after that we have to classify this number of cases to gyne and non-gyne for example how many the FNA and urine sputum CSF and the other classification will be by diagnosis the cases how many cases percentage unsatisfactory negative atypical or suspicious or positive malignancy and the number of unsatisfactory cases as we mentioned also as a quality indicator for liquid based cytology it should be around 1% if it is more than طبعا عندهم في checklist في نسب معينه لل unsatisfactory اذا كانت اكثر منها بيكون معناه there is a problem about either sampling or technical also we have on the annual statistic اللي هي a number of pap tests with the when we evaluate discrepancy and there is discrepancy between the cytology pap test and the histologic results and this discrepancy as we mentioned we classify as minor and major discrepancies the number of negative pap tests that were reclassified as abnormal دي طبعا في 10% rescreen when we are rescreening the 10% by cytology senior cytologist or cytology supervisor النسبة بتاعت ال reclassified as abnormal يعني هي missed by primary screening and also the number of pap reported as high grade or adenocarcinoma or other malignant with no histology follow up well history follow up sometimes is difficult I know sometimes the patient they will do surgery in another hospital and also we have to follow the histopathology report if is it available and then we have to correlate between cytology and the biopsy also we have to maintain the turnaround time in cytology what that turnaround time طبعا different from one type of specimen to another as general احنا بنقول مثلا turnaround time for gyne specimen or gyne smear بيكون within 5 working days اللي هي from a turnaround time from receiving of a specimen till the reporting of the specimen a turnaround time برضو the quality indicator عن الشغل بتاع اللاب بالنسبة لل non-gyne samples اللي هي within 2 working days طبعا في other factors to exclude اللي هي ما كل ال samples طبعا يعني مثلا في ال urine or CSF we can report within 2 days في sometimes some non-gyne samples need immunohistochemistry or additional tests so it will take more than 2 working days but generally هما في الـ في الـ احنا في الاس او بيز في اي لاب المفروض يكون عندنا turn around time حسب نوع السبيسيمنت فيها
باقي زي 5 minutes استاذ
اوكي طيب بالنسبه للسيفتي بريكوشن في الكومن تشيك ليست موجوده في كل اللاب عندنا سيفتي بريكوشن also related to cytology as you know, sometimes we handle potentially infectious material. Here, unfixed samples like sometimes sputum, respiratory samples, fluid, and CSF. Here, potential hazards. We have to prepare this sample under biologic safety hoods. طبعا عندنا two types of hoods. اللي هو الventilation hood there for only to prevent and the vapor of chemicals that we use in cytology lab. Here, for example, alcohol, xylene. فلازم يكون برضو كل ال staining under this hood. And biosafety hood also for infection material at cytology specimen. We have the also other precautions like fire precautions, PPE, اللي هي ال protective, personal protective equipment, طبعا safety shower or eye wash stations وكل ال procedure for how to handle the chemical spills أو splash في ال عندنا كثير من ال chemicals مثلا for example xylene or alcohol or stains دي كلها related طبعا مع ال مع safety precaution دائما بتكون related مع general بيسموها general checklist لأنه this is related لكل ال other department في اللاب also. في measures بالنسبة للسيفتي in the lab هي set by OSHA اللي هي Occupation Safety and Hazardous Authority. طبعا عندنا هنا example for اللي هو ال safety camera that we should process the infectious material under this safety hood or biologic safety cabinet in the lab. External quality assurance, it is a program of exchange of slides. طبعا احنا عندنا في السيتولوجي اللي هو زي الامتحان او البي تي اللي هو البروفيشنسي تيستينج. To pass this test, must attain an overall score of 90% or higher. Usually they send around 10 slides, for example, in Gynae or CAP. We have two programs here from ASCPi and College of American Pathologists. They send to the lab 10 slides of Gynae, for example. We have program for Gynae and for non-Gynae also. And the lab will submit the report on the results of these 10 cases. And after that, there will be evaluation and feedback from the CAP or from College of American Pathologists. And if there is any misses for malignant cases or high grade or something, there should be corrective action and evaluation in the report. بالنسبة لنا الـ PT طبعاً الـ cytology is different than other departments. الـ continuing medical education برضو is very important for the cytology. They should participate in like educational activities, online activities, courses, workshops, morphology workshops, and update courses because we have in the cytology there is change, يعني liquid-based cytology But we get terminology, different terminology systems in for thyroid or other type of specimen. We have to do a continuing medical education. طبعا النهاية بتاعت بالنسبة للpresentation دي الأهم point تقريبا اللي هي measures of screening performance. ودي أنا بحاول أشرحها بطريقة مبسطة للناس عشان زي ما قلنا إحنا الجولد ستاندرد بتاعنا هو البيوبسي. As general We have an accuracy, we have specificity, sensitivity, positive predictive value, and negative predictive value. طيب. طيب. In this slide, how we calculate the sensitivity, specificity, predictive value, and the accuracy in general. طبعا, of course, the test, when we say the test, In this case, this is the cytology report or the result from the cytology in the test. The outcome we have to compare it with the biopsy. If the test is positive and the outcome with the biopsy is also positive, so this we call it as A, which is a true positive. True positive, mana, this is agreement between cytology and biopsy, and it's positive and this is true positive. Type. For example, if the cytology is positive, test. And the outcome biopsy is negative. Biopsy is a gold standard, so this is false positive by cytology. Cytology got, for example, low grade or high grade, but it's negative. But here B, we have false positive. For example, also if the test is negative and the biopsy or the outcome is positive, so this is false negative. If both the test and the outcome negative, So it's a true negative, here D. So A is the true positive, B false positive, C false negative, and D true negative. دي سهلتلنا أن نعمل calculation of all quality or screening measures. اللي هنشوفه في ال second slide. So عرفنا أنه A, B, C, D. بعد ذاك نشوف sensitivity. Specificity and positive predictive value and negative predictive value. As general, the sensitivity of the test is dealing with the false negative result, as you know, sensitivity. طيب دي معناه شنو؟ معناه إذا كان أنا عندي كل ما كان عندي false negative أكثر، كل ما زاد false negative معناه sensitivity تبقى أقل. وبناخد example في in this case اللي هي sensitivity. إذا for example كان عندي true positive 10 cases will be divided by a true positive اللي هي 10 cases. طيب إذا تخيلنا أن false negative 0 مثلا ما في false negative معناه 10 divided by 10 في 100 معناها هتكون 100% sensitivity. The sensitivity 100% because there is no false negative. طيب كل ما زاد الفوز نيجاتيف هتقل السنسيتيفيتي. بالنسبه للسبي طبعا دي مستحيل طبعا حتى في السيتولوجي از امبوسيبل لكن احنا عشان نشرح بس للناس يعني. بالنسبه للسبيسيفيتي it is mainly concerned with the false positive result. So كل ما زاد false positive السبيسيفيتي will be decreased and will be affected. And as generally if you have true negative will be divided by true negative plus false positive اللي هي بعدها بنعمل calculation نشوف هي كم نسبتها يعني. For example also إذا كان عندي true negative 10 divided by 10 and false positive كان 2 for example فدي بيكون معنا 10 divided by 10 plus 2 بعدين بنضربها في 100 اللي بتطلع تقريبا 80% 80 something percent. فدي عمل calculation بيكون very easy اللي هو even for positive predictive value and negative predictive value. فبداية احنا we have to put all our finding in table and to compare between cytology and histopathology reports and to make it like A, B, C, D. And then after that we make calculation for all sensitivity, specificity, positive predictive value and negative predictive value. الجولد ستاندرد طبعا زي ما بقول كاب اللي هو every patient deserves the gold standard اللي هي الجولد ستاندرد عندنا في اللاب is هنا في السيتولوجي بيقول بايبسي طبعا this is only for calculation لكن the quality is feel all steps in the from the receiving to the reporting and as we mentioned also in the cap cytopathology checklist it's very detailed and very specific to each discipline in medical laboratory. There is CAP hematology, CAP microbiology, CAP molecular checklist. And this checklist where you can find the standards that the lab should be followed. هم داخلين كل الديتيلز اللي اتكلمنا عنها. اتكلم عن الستاف, عن البروسيدير, الـ SOPs. اتكلم عن الـ technical part, الـ statistics, الـ safety. مقسمين checklist لـ different parts. And a laboratory should every time try to comply and to follow the standard by cytopathology checklist. طبعا ممكن تشوف ال, to check the website CAP اللي هي CAP.org. In that one you will find all the information and documentation regarding this checklist and you will find different checklists for different and there is update هم كله تقريبا سنتين بيعمل update للتشيكليست. You can have a general idea about the cytopathology checklist. طبعا ما في cytopathology checklist لأن فيها كثير من من الستاندرز نتكلم عنها in details لكن دي فكرة عامة عن التشيكليست بتاعت الكاب. بالنسبة لنا احنا في cytopathology اللي هي most important accreditation لأنه الايسو والسي بي اي general بيتكلموا general عن اللاب والجي سي اي for the hospital لكن الكاب is discipline accreditation for each discipline in medical laboratory. طيب نختم بالفاني بيكتشر صورة مضحكة عن اللي احنا زمان قبل الاكريديتيشن كنا بنفتكر انه لما نقول في انسبكشن الناس بتكون بتفتكر انه الانسبكتور حيجي خاش كده بمسدس زي ما شايفين في الصورة ويسألك عن تيست ستيبس وتوريني الاس او بيز بتاعتك وريني التشيك ليست وكده. بعد ذاك اول انسبكشن اتذكر كان كاب انسبكشن تقريبا قبل 6 أو 7 سنوات لقيت انه الانسبكتور فيري نايس بيبول هم سيلكتد باي الكاب اتسلف طبعا هم بيكونوا باثولوجيست اور سينيور تكنولوجيست sometime human in Saudi Arabia, sometime in US, when you came in different countries. فهم ما بيفهم تفتيش انه يطلعوا لا فيه مشكله او غلطهم بيحاولوا انه to check if you follow the standards by CAP cytopathology checklist. واذا كان في مرات اذا في مشكله بيكون في مثلا بحطان في deficiency in certain part. بعدها بيكون في recommendation اللي هو corrective action how to improve your performance. And the inspection is not like the inspection. Yeah, it's really very educational activity. حتى بالنسبة للاب ستاف itself. يعني حتى بالنسبة للإنسبكتور ذاتهم. يعني مرات بيكتشفوا حاجة جديدة. They check everything. زي ما قلنا. عندك ال safety precautions. They check the SOPs. They check your procedure. And if you are following all the standards. And from receiving the specimen till the reporting of the sample. Thank you very much. شكرا. خلصنا المحاضرة معلش يعني topic شوية complicated ممكن يكون فيه كثير من النقاط بس زي ما عارفين الزمن محصور بيننا 40 minutes or 50 minutes بي دكتور الفاتح وإن شاء الله نلتقيكم مرة ثانية في محاضرات ثانية في different topics. شكرا جزيلا لكم.
شكرا جزيلا أستاذ محمد محاضرة قيمة جدا وهو طبعا لأنه الطبق كبير وأنت حاولت بقدر الإمكان غطيته يعني غطيت جزء كبير منه والمحاضرة فعلا هي مفيدة وكذلك حتى الكواليتي يعني مفيد لأغلب يعني حتى غير الناس السايتولوجي وأكيد المحاضرة ممكن يعني يفيد الطلاب ويفيد العاملين في مجال السايتولوجي والمادة حتكون موجودة على القناة باليوتيوب والتليجرام وكذلك اللايف هيكون موجود بالفيسبوك وأنا ممكن أفتح فرصة للأسئلة 5 دقائق إذا في سؤال ممكن just raise hand من الحضور الناس المتابعين على الفيسبوك اللي الاحتمال يكون في إشكال تكنيكال ما هنقدر ننقل الأسئلة من الفيسبوك للزوم لكن ممكن يعني نجمع الأسئلة ولاحقا ممكن نجاوب عليها إذا ما في أسئلة ممكن دكتور لو عندك إضافة تختم دقيقة كده أو دقيقتين
والله بتكلم عن الامبورتنس بتاعت بالنسبة للكواليتي طبعا في الميديكال لابوراتوري is very important زي ما عارفين و طبعا الاكريديتيشن عموما الكواليتي ستاندرز هي بتكون بتتحط مثلا عندنا البودي مثلا المينستر اوف هيلث وكده في حاجه بتكون لوكال بعدك في الانترناشونال اكريتيشن وكده فبنتمنى ان شاء الله مع التغيير الحاصل والانفتاح الحاصل في السودان انه يبدا برامج بتاعت اعتماد للمختبرات الطبيه الموجوده في السودان بانترناشونال اورجنايزيشنز زي الجي سي اي والكاب وكده ودي طبعا it will reflect انه يحصل improvement ل اللابوراتوري سيرفيس بشكل عام ان شاء الله في السودان.
ان شاء الله ان شاء الله ذلك وفي مجهود كبير يعني شايف يعني اغلب الشباب خارج السودان متحدين انه يعني يتعمل حاجه يعني خاصه اكريديتيشن بودي في مجال الكواليتي او يتعمل بروفيشنال بودي للمختبرات الطبيه نتمنى انه ان شاء الله ترى النور قريب وانا شاكر جدا استاذ وإن شاء الله نلتقي في المحاضرات القادمة إذا مضى الله في الأجال السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
عليكم السلام وشكرا جزيلا شكرا كثير
شكرا الله يكرمك